Okay, welcome back to another edition of Inside the Box. Danny Hogan, along with the coach.
What's going on, big boy? We're back.
We're back.
Yes, sir.
What a week in the NFL. All I got to say, can I get a J-E-T-S, Jets, Jets, Jets from you, coach, or what?
J-E-T-S, Jets, Jets,
Jets. Unbelievable. I cannot believe that the New York Jets are in the AFC Championship game. It could be my year. God is smiling upon me. The football gods are upon the New York Jets. We are one game away. Incredible games in the week. We were able to take care of business, right, going on the road, 7-0 lead, shutting down the Colts, the Chargers. Mr. Tomlinson and co. held him to nothing. Get this thing the hell out of here. I'm sick of it.
I'm fired up.
I can't believe it. Listen, as a Jet fan, this opportunity doesn't come along too often.
Must every 35, 40 years.
Take it easy, coach. We were there 11 years ago, right? And we should have won that game. Curtis Martin, of course. This is why the Jets are cursed, and I think we're exercising the demons with Mr. Rex.
So, let's talk about recap those games.
I got to calm down.
Let's talk about the game. All right. Down 7-0.
Okay.
Right? Mm-hmm. Come back, string hold. Take their best punches. They said in the newspaper all week, take their best punch.
Absolutely.
Tell me your thoughts about that game.
Well, listen.
What are you thinking about that game?
Again, Rex's formula. Ground and pound. You know, wear the opponent down. You know, get to the quarterback. Hit the quarterback. Like Rex said, you hit that quarterback, the whole entire team feels it. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
That's why Nate Kading, he was scared for his life.
Guys missed getting up two there. Field goals all year.
Exactly. He's up there, he's trembling. He was scared for Philip Rivers.
You think so?
I don't. And a lot of people could say, Sanchez is not winning these games. He's not doing anything. You know what? He's making plays when he has to make plays.
Absolutely.
I mean, he scrambled, bought himself time, you know, let Keller make a move to get open, and he hit him right where he had to hit him.
That was a tremendous catch.
Yeah, absolutely.
That was a tremendous catch. You saw that replay. The tight end went out, did an out pattern, came to the corner Enzo, came back towards the quarterback when he saw him stop.
Yep.
And that ball was had some zip on it.
Oh, absolutely.
It was a bullet pass to the end zone, and when he caught that ball, I said, these guys are going to win this game.
Amazing.
These guys are seriously going to win this game.
You know, and then you get another rookie, like, you know, a lot of youth with the Jets winning this ball game. You know, then you get Sean Green just hitting the hole,
breaks
the tackle.
Huge.
I mean, this kid is a game breaker every game.
Right.
I mean, Leon Washington went down. I thought that was it.
Right.
Sean Green, you know, he hasn't fumbled in a while. Let's hope that continues. But he really stepped up to the plate in this
Absolutely.
Game. And, you know, hey, listen, now we're going against Indy and the big bad Colts. You know, Indy, of course, we'll talk about best bets real quick.
Before we get to that game, let's recap real quickly the Vikings versus the Saints.
Okay.
I'm sorry, not the Vikings, it'll be Vikings and Saints, but the big win over the Cowboys by the Saints.
Over the Vikings.
Right, over the Vikings,
Mm-hmm.
Right, so let's recap that game.
Listen, you know, first of all, Romo, I'm sorry, he's not a big-time quarterback.
Right.
This guy is not, he's a fantasy quarterback.
Right.
Puts up big statistics during the year. That's
right.
It, all right? Not to say that he had a lot of time. Mm-hmm. The Vikings defense played tremendous. They were all over.
All over.
He never had a second.
Right.
But you know what? I mean, come on, some of those throws, I mean, when they were still in the game in the third, late in the third, and he threw that ball right to the linebacker.
But a lot of pressure.
But in that game, you have to see that linebacker.
Right.
Listen, I know he was on fire all day.
His potential down, we'll talk about this later on.
Yeah,
his
absolutely.
Potential. The Vikings beat the Saints. The Jets beat
the
Colts.
The Jets got the Vikings.
Got number 5 coming back to New York. Against New York, this could be some story.
The storylines for the Super Bowl have potential to be great no matter what.
A lot has to happen, but his potential to have a great
potential,
story.
Absolutely.
A great
but,
story.
I mean, you know, you could have the Colts playing the Saints, his hometown team.
Right.
You know what I mean? You got the Saints and their story with everything that's gone on with the Hurricane. You got Peyton Manning, the great Peyton Manning, in the Super Bowl again for the second time.
That's right.
Or, you know, you got the Vikings, Brett Favre back in the Super Bowl. Or you get the Jets, rookie head coach, rookie quarterback, all the headlines.
Absolutely.
They're in the Super Bowl. Either which way, you got a great story.
I'm pumped up.
But the best story for the Super Bowl, obviously, would be Jets taking off.
Absolutely.
And the Jets have a chance to exercise so many demons along the way.
Right.
I'm sorry to steal your thunder here, Coach.
No, I'm letting you go.
I'm exploding. I'm shut out of the cannon here. You know, first they said, you know, Bengals rested players. Jets took care of them.
Right.
You know, now, you know, the Colts took off. Now they got an opportunity to take care of them.
Right.
Then if they can get Favre, what a storybook.
Absolutely.
They'll exercise every demon.
Comes full circle.
Pound him. Slam him to the turf.
Let's talk quickly about the Jets versus the Colts. What do you got? What's going on?
Obviously, I'm taking the Jets in that game, of course. You know, but it's going to be a very tough game to win. I mean, Peyton Manning, with the way he's precision routes, he gets that ball off so fast.
Made some mistakes against the Ravens. A couple of interceptions.
Absolutely.
One got overturned.
Absolutely.
One lost in a fumble.
That was passing the
fence. That was passing the fence, but they got overturned.
No, you're right.
And also, when he made the mistakes, he had the ability to get his composure back, and he just dinks. He's a dinker. I don't care what anybody says.
He is a dinker.
10, 12 yards. He's so accurate.
Not really a dinker. He had laser precision.
They are. But
it is a dinker.
He chops him up.
Yeah, he chops
him up, and
he
makes moves those chains.
Exactly.
So cerebral, so precise.
The guy in third and shorts.
What are the Jets going to do to stop him? What are the keys to victories for the Jets to stop the Colts?
The Jets cannot get
Give me one key.
They can't get into third and shorts. They can't allow the Colts to get yardage allowed on the first down.
Okay.
They have to keep the Colts in the third and longs.
Blitz allowed on first down?
Oh, they're going to come after him all day.
All day.
The problem
with
that is Peyton Manning on these short routes and these lasers and all the way his wide receivers run routes, they pick up the blitz well.
Sure.
It's so tough. He picks you apart with the blitz.
So keep it third and long.
You got to keep it third and long because he's third and shorts. He
go out in the first couple of downs.
Absolutely.
All right,
but
good.
The key is to get in Peyton Manning's face. I mean, the Patriots did it in a couple of AFC Championship games where they got in his face and pounded him and it rattled him.
Manning has been sacked only 10 times the whole year.
Amazing.
He was hit only 5 times in that game last week. And even though he made a couple of mistakes against the Ravens, he comes back. He keeps coming. And he makes adjustments.
Oh, absolutely.
So I'm just letting you know, you say getting to his face, but it's very difficult. It's been proven all season long. But on the other side, the Colts have to keep the pressure on.
Absolutely.
Two wins, Freeney. Mm-hmm. All right, Freeney, he keeps bringing it.
Oh, right? God.
Freeney keeps bringing it. These guys are tremendous pass rushers. So
absolutely.
They got to put pressure on the Jets.
And they have a lot of speed. They have a lot of speed on defense.
Get them third and long.
Yeah, and that's the key for them as well. Absolutely.
Keep the Jets third and long. So
I'm going to take the Jets in this game, Colts. Coach yourself, you going with the Colts?
Listen, I want to break up your fairy tale right here. Mm-hmm. But I just can't see how they can beat the Colts.
Oh,
and I've been off. Okay. I've been off. You can
so
check
we got the tape. We got some money on that?
Got some money on this.
Okay, quick little side thing. Quick, the best bets this week. We're going to be donating. We're going to be serious. No, we're going to be donating them to
the
Haitian, the Haiti fund.
Right.
We ask our viewers, you know, text Haiti. Let's, you know, support the relief operation going over there.
Absolutely. Tragedy was going
on.
We're going to do our best to support them.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Absolutely.
All right.
So quickly, let's jump into the, now that we address the AFC. Saints looked incredible against the Colts.
Cardinals. That was never a game.
Saints look incredible, clicking on all
Vikings destroyed Dallas.
What do you think, Coach? Who do you like in this game?
This one's a toss up. Me, I've been going back and forth with this. I really don't know. I love Drew Brees.
Mm-hmm.
I like what he's done. I think he was a favorite to win the MVP. Peyton got it, but I think he's right there with Peyton. I like the Saints because they're home. That's the only reason why.
Yep.
If the Vikings were home, I'm going home team wins, and I'm talking about a close game, a lot of points.
Yep.
Close game, a lot of exciting plays.
So 3.5 point spread. 3.5 points. You can take it.
Absolutely.
I'll take the Vikings in this game.
Are you?
Yeah.
I'll
20 in this. I just think the defense plays so tremendously against the Cowboys. I'm thinking maybe they can get the pressure on Brees. At home, true.
At home.
But you know what? This is in a dome as well. Dome team.
But
so.
It's at home. The home field makes a huge difference with these two teams.
Yep. Absolutely.
Huge difference.
Yep. So
all right.
That's it. That's our best bets. Listen, I gotta take a couple seconds on this one, Coach, please.
Okay.
LeBron James.
What's going on? LeBron James.
Come on. This is ridiculous. This guy goes on record, you know, last year at the slam dunk contest, throws his name in a hat, wants to be part of the slam dunk contest, and now all of a sudden he withdraws. He's not in it. It's a disgrace. This is like A-Rod not joining the home run derby at Yankee Stadium a couple of years ago, okay? You know what I have a problem with this, Coach? This game is for the fans. All right.
Go to the camera. Go get him.
Game is for the fans. All these guys should be participating. Kobe, everybody. If you don't have an injury, you should be at this event. What do you think?
I was watching NBA.TV.com last night, and Shaq, his lawyer, said that if you bring out Vinsanity, you bring out Kobe, the Black Mamba, you bring out LeBron will come out and play. His client will come out and play. Dunk the ball. I'm saying, as you agree with you, these guys should come out there and have some fun. It's an NBA. It's fans weekend. Come out, give a good show to the fans.
That's right.
And I want to see Kobe going against LeBron. I would love this, like it's Michael Jordan against
Dominique Wilkins.
Right?
All the greats did it.
Let's do it.
Exactly.
Put it on.
I'm calling you out, LeBron. Join the slam dunk contest.
Loser.
Coach, great show.
Good show.
Listen, enjoy the AFC Championship, NFC Championship games. Good luck to your teams. We'll see you next week on Inside the Box. Hey everybody, it's the Bostonian. Bad week for us. Does it get any worse? Jets and Colts in the AFC Championship, and Uncle Teddy's seat went to a Republican. Really bad week.